Good morning and Jai Hind. Dear parents, students, respected members of the board, administrators and teachers. It's a moment of pride to host this topper's appreciation ceremony of class 10 world achievers of Sandeep Sunset. This ceremony is special because it not only acknowledges and honors the students for their outstanding performance, also give such moments of jubilation and pride in equal measures to the staff, teachers and parents. The relentless efforts with focus along with steady guidance over a period of time results in such momentous achievement. Once again, on behalf of the entire Sunbeam Sun City staff members, I congratulate the achievers. Just to let you know that the ceremony is now live on Sunbeam One and Sunbeam Sun City School and Hostel Varanasi's Facebook pages. Before we begin today's program, I would like to acknowledge the presence of Assistant Director Mrs. Pratima Gupta.
Thank you.
And CEO Mr. Ashish Rai. Thank you for gracing this event with your presence, ma'am and sir. Before we begin the program, ma'am, would you like to say something before we start?
Well, it is always a wonderful feeling to celebrate the achievements of your students, because what is really heartening is that when you see the results come out, though I'm not one to actually say that marks and percentages and grades are everything, that is the only thing in your life, but when I see the results and when those little butterfly moments happen, as when the result comes out and you start tracking the names, so on and so forth. You actually register the percentages later. What you recall in your mind's eye is the little conversations you've had with them as the run-up to the preparation of the exams. Some of them you talk to when they did not perform so well in the half-yearlies or in the pre-boards. Some of them you recall, when you have taken their admission, probably as young nervous kids in the junior classes. Some of them you recall as having shared moments of preparations for a debate or a speech or an elocution or an inter-house or an inter-school competition. So for me, very honestly, it is not 99 upon 100 or 98 upon 100 in chemistry or say 95 upon 100 in history which registers. What registers is the child, the student, the person. And I'm happy celebrating that individual for the reaping of efforts. That is a thought which crosses my mind. And I want to tell all my toppers that yes, we are clapping for you. Yes, we are glad for you. But you know what? This is a milestone. This is a temporary billboard advertising something, yet another wonderful that you have done. This by no means is the end to your achievements. And this by no means is the end of the applause that we want to give you for every single thing that you will continue to do hereafter in your life. So what I cherish is my moments with
Are
you.
We audible?
Therefore, yes, I think sir has joined in. Chairman,
yes, sir.
Yeah. So to all the students out there who are joined, have joined us today, and to some of those who are there on Facebook, each one of you is special. Each one of you is unique, and whether you scored 95 or you scored 65, believe me, you're as precious to all of us. And that one exam has to be celebrated. The results have to be celebrated. But as I always say, the book of life and the grades and percentages you get therein, that is the greater celebration that we should all do together. Because I know you have gone out, or you are there in Sandeep with us with all these wonderful little talents intact. So keep shining, Sandeeps.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for such words. I would request, I know that Chairman sir will be busy from 12 o'clock. He has to go live. Sir, if you would like to address the gathering.
Thank you so much, Gideon sir. Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Can you hear me?
Yes, sir. We can hear you. Yes, sir.
Okay. Gideon, sir, thank you so much for giving me a chance early today, because there is a huge deluge of meetings these days online, the whole world. Now, first of all, congratulations to my wonderful Sun Cityans or the Sunbeam Flowers of Sun City. What a great result. And every year I can see that you are increasing your percentage average marks. The average mark per child in Sun City has gone up by a few notches. And it's the hard work of the teachers. I can see, I can feel that every year, teachers, our PGTs, our primary section teachers, they are all becoming better and better. You now know how to crack the difficult chapters. And this year we had quite a few 100 out of 100s, and the above 90 scores of Sun City has also gone up substantially. My congratulations to the principal, Archana ma'am, and to the coordinators, the vice principal, and obviously the junior school, which is the foundation. Also, congratulations to the faith in us and motivating. And we know very well how hard it is for the parent also, because the mothers and fathers are all excited and all helping out with the students. Sun City, a new school, but now Sun City is an all-rounder school. It's a school which can teach you everything. It can teach you life skills, sports, and above all, be very good in academics as well. We are missing the children here. Every time we pass Galaxia or Odeon or go to Resonance and see the wonderful swimming pool, and we just wonder, we can, our ears are buzzing with the sounds of children actually. I can sometimes hear children running around, and then I think to myself, how long this is going to be. Let's hope for the best. Let's pray for the best. Stay at home, everyone, and try to take all chances of studying. The online classes of your school are going on. We must make sure that we do not waste our time. Once again, very, very warm congratulations to all of you. Let's work hard for the next year. This will pass, and soon we'll be back to school. And then we will value the things which we thought were everyday things, the common things like running and playing basketball or sitting down on a bench with your friend. Those are the things which every child I know is looking out of the window and dreaming about their school, their friends, because how long can you stay in an apartment or a room or a house? So as a at home and we study hard. Congratulations to all of you one more time. Thank you so much, and Jai Hind.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much for gracing the event. I would also request our director, Mrs. Bharti Madho, to address the gathering.
Thank you, Brijesh sir. I'm so happy and excited to be with all of you. I hope all of you can hear me.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. We can hear you clearly.
Okay, fine, great. So, Sun City, the most loved school, in my opinion, because whenever we are here, almost every day we are here, and it's such a pleasure seeing those green ground and the swimming pool. And when I was seeing the video which Girish sir you have made and which you have sent to the children, I'm sure the children must have got a lump in their throat after seeing that video. You know, it's not only the knowledge or information which you get from school, it is that association, that one-to-one connect, that those smiles of your teachers, those fights with your friends, those canteen days. There is so much to us, all that But having said that, you guys are lucky. At least you were there regularly in the school in grade 10 and grade 12. But imagine those children who have taken admission in class 11th this year. They are not even attending the class. They are sitting at home. They have not even seen their rooms in the hostel. So you are lucky, children. At least you were there and you were doing. You have done all the mischief in life which you wanted to. So congratulations for that. Having said that, life is not only about a report card. I'll always insist that life is a total experience. It's a journey. It's just not a destination. So every day, keep moving. With the new changes, the way we are now educating you or passing on the information to you, you have to grab even that opportunity. Don't wait for a sunny day. You have today, we cannot come to school, but at least we can do online studies. So please focus on that, focus on learning, focus on personal growth, then dedicated. They are so dedicated. I'm telling you, the way they are working, even now, I'm sitting at Sun City and I can see so many of the teachers coming and trying to reach out to the children by all means. Sometimes we don't get good Wi-Fi connection, but yes, we still want to somehow reach up to you. So dear children, I hope you appreciate what's happening around you and how much your staff, your teachers are struggling. And I hope you will also come out of this COVID, come out of this pandemic much stronger and much ready for the world. With this, congratulations to all the students who have done well. May the, you know, God be on your side also, and may you see even better days ahead. God bless.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you so much for those kind words. Now I would request Principal Sunbeam Sun City to share Sunbeam Sun City's class 10th board result analysis. Over to you, ma'am.
Yeah, good morning, and Jai Hind, everyone. Good morning, and Jai Hind. I would like to start my result analysis with this beautiful quote. First of all, I would like to extend a warm welcome to the dignitaries, the Sunbeam board members, to all my dear parents, students, my dear teachers, and to the two beautiful anchors who we have today. Excellence is never an accident. It is the result of high intention, sincere effort, intelligent direction, skillful execution, and the vision to see obstacles and opportunities. With these inspiring thoughts, I present the class 10th board result before my parents and students and the dignitaries. 231 students appeared for class 10th in the year 2020. And this is a very proud moment to share that all the students passed with flying colors. That gives Sunbeam Sun City 100% result. I would also like to share that the school average is 80%. 80% school average means that each child of Sunbeam Sun City has secured 80% minimum. That is the school average of Sunbeam Sun City. Presenting before you the topper of Sunbeam Sun City, Miss Ananya Pandey. As you can see, her marks, all the nines, 99 in English, 98 in Hindi, 99 in mathematics, 92 in science, and 98 in social science. That makes her the highest scorer of Sunbeam Sun City with 97.2%. Now I present before you the 10 toppers of Sunbeam Sun City who are all in 90s. As I just said, Ananya Pandey with 97.2%, Avishkar Upadhyay with 96.8%, Shivam Verma with 96.8%. So we have two second rank holders at Sunbeam. Mr. Tanish Ginodia with 96.6%, Mr. Abhijit with 96.2%, Shivam Verma 96%. The other top 10 is Tanya Singh, Nandini with 95.8%, 95%. Chitish Kumar Singh, yes, he is the max stalwart with 95%, Uday Tripathi with 94.8%, Harshit Singh Rawat, 94.6%, again another Max Stalwart, Aditi Ambe with 94.2%. These are the top 10s of Sunbeam Sun City. The subject scorers with the highest in different subjects, I present before you Miss Ananya Pandey with 99 marks in English, Divyanshi Singh with 99 marks in English, Sunidhi Rai, 99 in English, and Vipasha Bhattacharya, the reader, with 99 in English. The other subject toppers are Ananya Pandey, 98 in Hindi, Satyam Tripathi with 98 in Hindi, and the next subject topper in French is Shivam Verma with 98 marks. Sanskrit, people say it's very easy to get 100. I really don't know because children have really worked up, are very hard for it. Avishkar Upadhyay securing 100 in Sanskrit, Tanish Ginodia with 100 in Sanskrit, Abhijit, another Max Stalwart, 100 in mathematics. The other subject toppers, as I just said, Chitesh Kumar Singh, 100 in mathematics, Shivam Verma with 97 in science, and Nandini, also a basketball champion, with 100 in social science. The subject average. The subject average plays a very important role to understand the teachers teaching the enrichment classes and how exactly the school works when it comes to academics. So presenting before you the subject average in English, 85.3%. And just to specify, the subject average showcases that this is the maximum marks that a child has secured. So 85.32 in English, 85 in Hindi, Sanskrit with 97.33, French 71.47, mathematics with 74.28, science with 67, and social science with 88.94. These are the subject average of Sunbeam Sun City, which has increased by 1 or 2% for different subjects. Before I present the number of students who fall under different percentage category, these are the percentages of the students falling under different percentage. Just to inform, 123 students of Sunbeam Sun City have secured more than 80%. And around 50 students of Sunbeam Sun City have got 90% and above. So that is the percentage of students, which is very high when I talk about a 10-year-old school. The graph showcases the heights of the percentage. Well, before I end, these are the Sunbeam Sun Cityans class 10th appearing students. 231 students, they want to say, success isn't always about greatness. It is about consistency. Consistent hard work leads to success. Greatness will surely come. Before I end, I want to thank all my dear parents, all students and the achievers who have started this journey along with all of us at Sunbeam Sun City. I also want to express my gratitude to all my staff members and also the board dignitaries who have entrusted faith and who have given their wholehearted support and cooperation as great mentors to Sunbeam Sun City. Keep shining, Sunbeam Sun City, and keep supporting dear board members. Thank you and Jai Hind.
Thank you so much, ma'am. As we are joined by the toppers of Sunbeam Sun City along with their parents, now the co-host of the program, I would like to invite Yash and Apurva to take a Q&A session with these people. I introduce the anchors, Apurva Dubey and Yash Jaiswal. Please take this.
Thank you, sir. It's a wonderful feeling to host today's event because being a Sunbeam, there's nothing more delightful than to see the success of students of our alma mater. To begin with the Q&A session, may I please invite the topper, Ms. Ananya Pandey, who has secured 97.2% in the class 10th board exams. Congratulations, Ms. Ananya.
Thank you.
Ananya, I've often observed you in school and you are a sincere student. an ardent reader and also a brilliant orator. So we would like to know, what goal did you set for yourself and how did you execute the plan to achieve it?
First of all, good afternoon and Jain, everyone. I hope I'm audible.
Yes, you're audible.
Anu. Yes, you're audible.
Talking about strategies, I really follow two things, consistency and not giving up. I'll be very honest. I did not put in 7 to 8 hours of study. I only studied 3 hours a day, but I did give the book 100% attention during those 2 to 3 hours. The idea was to stay in touch with the books constantly without missing a day, paying attention to what was taught in the school, revising it on my own when I came back home, and not giving up on the topics that I found a little difficult were the few things that really worked out well for me.
Thank you, Ananya. We also have the proud parents of Miss Ananya along with us. Congratulations, sir and ma'am.
Thank you, Apurva.
So please tell us, how did you feel when you got to know that Ananya is the topper of Sun City in class 10th?
It was a pride moment for us, and all credit goes to the Sunwind Sun City team, especially the guidance of Principal Ma'am Archana Ma'am and all the teachers. What I feel that for this achievement, very important thing is that interest towards the study. If interest is there, then everybody can achieve this type of result. So I think Sunwind Sun City team has done a wonderful job towards this. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Once again, congratulations to all of you. Moving on, I would like Mr. Yash to take over.
Thank you, Apurva. We have Shubham Verma securing 96.8% and scoring highest marks in French. A well-rounded academic scholar with zeal to experiment in everything while pursuing and achieving excellence. He has been inactively participating in competitions like Confest and has also won the science exhibition and has a great debating skills. Shivam, I would like to ask you that, how did you create a balance between the co-curriculars and the academics?
Thank you for the question. First of all, Jain to everyone. Honestly speaking, the best strategy to achieve something is to put all your effort. And coming to the question, co-curriculars have been interesting throughout the school year, but that didn't push me away from my academic. And that should not push anyone away from the academic. Co-curriculars and academic should go together. For this, I completely thank my teachers for the support they have shown and for the guidance that they didn't allow me to repel from the academic. And thanks to Principal Ma'am also kept on reminding me that I am a board student. And thanks to my family, and thank you. Jai.
Thank you, Shivam. It seems you are strategically set to achieve your goals. Over to Apurva.
Once again, congratulations, Shiva. Further on, we have amidst us Mr. Avishkar Upadhyay, who has secured 96.8% in his board exams and has also got a perfect 100 score in Sanskrit. Congratulations, Avishkar. Avishkar is a punctual and laborious student and is also humble and respectable with all his peers and teachers. So, Avishkar, you have been studying as a day scholar in Sun City for a long time. We would like to know, what did Sunbeam Sun City provide you in assistance that led to your success?
Thank you for the question first. Good afternoon and Jai Hind, everyone. Sunbeam Sun City has provided me very significant support in my journey, from providing a healthy environment for studies in class till the informative assemblies. The school management role was very beneficial in my day-to-day life. I would like to thank Principal Ma'am, Akansha Ma'am, Usha Ma'am, and all my respected teachers for supporting, guiding and motivating me to learn and perform. My teachers have helped me to handle my academics very well. Also, they used to give me perfect guidelines from time to time so that I could do my preparation at very best level. Like in the subjects in which I was too much weak, like in Sanskrit, I have got 100, but this is just because of my teacher Raghavan sir. He used to give us his own made worksheet for practice so that I can become perfect in that subject and secure good marks. And all my other subject teachers also helped me a lot. They also helped me to maintain consistency in all my subjects. Also, the exams, the internal exams held in school, like the pre-board and the periodic tests, they also helped me to prepare because they were giving my analysis every time that how much I have to prepare further. Thank you, and Jay.
Thank you, Avishkar, and well said. Teachers are the guide who actually lead us towards success. Moving on, we have amidst us the Honorary Director, Sunbeam Group, Mr. Harsh Madhok. Sir, may I please request you to address all the toppers and their parents.
Good afternoon, and I would like to congratulate all the toppers of Sun City, not just the toppers, all the children who have appeared in the 10th exams this year. So congratulations all of you for a phenomenal result. I believe this year's percentage is one, and average percentage marks is 1.5% more than what it was last year. And special congratulations for Ananya for being the topper of Sun City. Well done. And a lot of this credit goes to your teachers, the ones who have prepared you children, and to your parents as well, because that discipline and that routine has to be inculcated, and it's never just your effort. It's always a group effort of the parents also involved. So congratulations to all the parents for a wonderful, wonderful results. And I know this time right now we're going through the COVID era, in which things are not certain and there's a lot of uncertainty there. And I'm sure in class 11th most of you must be taking up Zoom classes right now, because we don't have alternative to do real classes. So just keep yourself updated, and don't miss out on your studies, because now you have your 12th boards in 2021, in 22. So I hope that all of you are working hard, having that goal in at the end of your at the back of your mind, because the journey is not complete yet. So with that, once again, congratulations to all of you. Jai Hind.
Thank you, sir. The next topper put on the spot is Tanish Ginodia, who is a boarder securing 96.6% and 100% marks in Sanskrit, the silent mark amongst the peers and the forever smiling individual. Tanish has always been a focused student. Congratulations, Tanish, for your achievement. My question to you is, apart from the regular classes, you have also attended the hostel classes. How were you benefited from the enrichment classes?
Thank you for the question. First of all, good afternoon and Jai Hind to all. I always focus in night studies, as and all the daytime I was always sleeping. I also want to thank Ashish sir, Bhushan sir, and my warden Sachin sir and Rajni sir for the support and guidance. If you check my scores in Sanskrit of class 9th, it was very bad. Like out of 80, I was only scoring 50 to 55. But in class 10th, I had scored the highest marks in Sanskrit. It is only because of Raghavan sir. He took my extra classes in hostel also and in school also. And I would like to thank all my teachers, Akansha ma'am, Ravi Shankar sir, and all my teachers for the support and guidance.
Thank you, Shivam. Thank you, Tanish. Once again, congratulations. Apurva, I would like you to introduce the next topper.
Well then, let me introduce you all with Mr. Abhijit, who has secured 96.2% in his board exams and a perfect 100 score in mathematics. Congratulations, Abhijit. Abhijit is a well-mannered student and also a brilliant orator. He tackles all the activities and assignments in an organized manner. On this note, let me tell you all that he has also represented our school in the CBSE National Science Exhibition and emerged as winner. We are proud of all your achievements. So Abhijit, please tell us, what is that one advice that you would like to give to your immediate juniors who will be appearing for the board exams next year?
First of all, good afternoon and Jai Hind to everyone. And thank you for the question. So the one message which I want to give to all my juniors is that now the time has come when you all have to be honest to yourself. Honest means that you have to become more responsible and you have to take your own responsibility. Now in junior classes, when you were in class 8th, 7th or 9th, so that time there have been many years that your teachers and your parents have been taking care of you, have been giving more care, have been guiding you all. But now also this year also, I know that all the teachers would be putting up their more effort, their guidance towards you all. But you also have to put your own effort. You have to be responsible towards yourself. You have to be honest with your studies, whatever you are doing. It has not to be just like showcasing the things. Like there are few students who just show that they're studying. They have opened up the book. But actually, just to show the parents that they are studying. And the real is that they do not study, they are not studying, but they are actually showing their that they are studying. So this has not to be happened. You have to be honest to yourself. This is the one. And second is that I want you all that there will be many unit tests and half yearly pre-boards which will be conducted before the board examinations. So you take it seriously. You set your target in those examinations as well. But for your final target, it has to be always your board examination. So if you, if you are not able to achieve the target in your pre-board examinations or unit test examinations, so you don't have to become upset. You don't have to let yourself down and you don't have to lose your hope. You have to maintain your hope for achieving achieving those all goals which you have saved for your board examinations. So you have to always keep hope and you have to keep practicing for it. You have to put in your 100% effort. And I must say that if you put your 100% effort and your hard work, then nothing is going to let you down. Nothing is going to stop you from scoring that whatever the marks you have set for your board examination, that is going to stop you for achieving that. Thank you.
Rightly said, Abhijit. Consistency, hard work, and honesty are the keys that will lead us to success. To introduce everyone with the next topper, here is Yash.
Thank you, Apurva. Introducing to the next achiever, Shivam Verma, who has secured 96% and also is also a science topper. A well-mannered student with a never-give-up attitude when facing a task that is difficult. Shivam, you have been an active student in both the co-curriculars and the academics. So my question to you is, what are your future goals and how are you preparing for it?
Good morning and Jane everyone, and thanks for the question. My future goals are that I have to be an IITian. I have to graduate from an IIT college. So for that, I have joined GRS online teaching institute. And for that, I am also working very hard. So I would also like to recommend everyone that it is a very good opportunity for everyone to gain what they want, and they can be success. They can gain the success in this time because it's very good opportunity for everyone. And lastly, I would like to thank every teacher who helped me to score 96% marks. Thank you.
Thank you, Shivam. I'm sure you are going to achieve everything you desire with focus and conviction you have. I now request the COO of Sunbeam Group, Mr. Ashish Rai, to address the students, parents, and the staff members.
Good afternoon, and Jai Hind, everyone. And congratulations to all the achievers. We are extremely contented with your performance. Well done, and continue the good work. Congratulations to all the teachers as well. But my real gratitude, my sincere gratitude and congratulations, especially to the parents of these students, because I firmly believe that it is because of your nurturing, that they have been so sincere and focused. It is entirely your effort and the virtues you have inculcated because of which these students have been able to perform so well. Dear students, I wish you all the luck and continue to grow every day. This success should not be taken as a milestone achieved, because education is not about achieving a milestone. It has a larger objective and it has to happen every day till the very last day of our life. Education has a larger cause and gradually you will understand it. So keep progressing. Don't let COVID obstruct your progress and your development. One last thing I would like to say, there is too much of vacuum in the campus. I was there yesterday and believe me, there was too much of emptiness and vacuum without you all. Ronak hi jaise gayab hai. So missing you all and wish this ends, this passes by and we are back to normal and our campus is again bright as ever. Well done, students. Jai Hind.
Thank you, sir. Moving on, we next have Ms. Tanya Singh, who has secured 95.8% in her board exams. Tanya is a polite and tenacious student. Her teachers have only good things to say about her. So, Tanya, you are an NCC cadet from our school who has been participating in all the camps and relevant events, which has indeed led you to miss out a few of your classes as well. So please tell us, how did you keep up the pace of your studies?
First of all, good morning and Jai Hind, and thank you for the question. Talking about NCC, NCC didn't affected my studies, and besides it, NCC brought a lot of confidence within me and increased my concentration. And another thing that proved to be really helpful was the guidance and support of my teacher. Thank you.
Okay, so we have some network issues with Ms. Tanya. While we get back with Ms. Tanya, we'll move on further and Yash will take you further to introduce with the next topper.
Thank you, Apurva. Now, securing 95% in the board results and 100% marks in social science, we have the captain of the girls' basketball team, Ms. Nandini, one of the sharpest and the most creative mind who makes every turf her own from classroom to playground in the smallest time. Nandini, my question to you is, how has sports contributed in your success in curriculars?
First of all, good afternoon and then to all the respected dignitaries, my the guardians and my dear friends. First of all, I would like to pay my humble gratitude to my parents, my teachers and all who have supported me in my journey to 95. Yes, basketball has taught me a very specific, a moral thing in my life, that if you miss a shot, no matter how perfect it is, just collect the rebound and go for the dunk, which means that if you have targeted for 90 and you just didn't get at 90%, you just got 85 or something, don't be upset of that. Yeah, go and just go for 95. Then you can make some improvement in yourself. Thank you.
Thank you, Nandini. We also have Nandini's mother amidst us. Ma'am, as a parent, aapne Nandini ko full support kiya hai. Ek abhibhavak ke taur par aap agle saal board pariksha mein sammilit hone wale students ke abhibhavakon ko kya sandesh dena chahengi?
मैं ही संदेश दूंगी कि यहाँ बहुत ही अच्छे तरह बच्चे को पढ़ाया जा रहा है, रिस्पॉन्स है वहाँ का, तो अपने बच्चे को यहीं पर रखें और मतलब यहाँ पूरा भरोसा दिया जाता है कि बच्चों को अच्छे से पढ़ाया जाता है, तो अपने बच्चों को यहीं पर रखें और यहीं पढ़ाएं।
Okay, so we'll move further. And next we have with us Mr. Anurag Srivastava, who has secured a 93.2% in his board exams. Anurag, you have been a part of our school's quiz club, with multiple quizzing events like the heritage quiz, science quiz, cultural quiz, and many more. You have added a lot of stars to your shoulders as well as to the name of our school. We want to know, why did you take up quizzing, which is a time-consuming activity, and how did you strike a balance between quizzing and your studies?
First of all, good afternoon and Jain to one and all present here, and thank you for the question. I try to manage both my quiz and studies simultaneously by putting adequate importance on my time management schedule. And I was having an extreme passion towards quizzing, so I didn't take that as a bigger stress for it. I was regular and focused towards self-study, which helped me a lot, around 2 hours throughout the year, which helped me a lot. Many times due to quiz and various competitions, I was not able to attend regular classes in the school. So after that, when I am free, or I used to go to my teachers and seek their help so that they can clear my doubt. Now talking about a subject which is a nightmare for many of the students, is mathematics. The same was in my case. I have got only 35 marks in pre-board 2, but after that, with the help of Dilip sir and Upen sir, I got 97 marks, which is greater than all the subjects which I got in board exams. And at last, I would like to thank all my mentors, especially Ashish sir, Principal ma'am, Abhinav sir, and all my teachers for this bit. And it's not my success, it's all your success. It is only, I only got this bit with your help. Thank you.
Thank you, Anurag, for sharing your experience with us and also a few tips for the further quizzes. Next, we have with, moving on, may I please request Assistant Director of Sunbeam Group, Mrs. Pratima Gupta, to please address all the students and their parents.
Ma'am, we know you have already addressed, but we would like to know that exactly what is the feeling, because we were just in this month, July 11th, we celebrated our Founders Day. And this is our 10th year of existence. From there to now, I was just watching that video and it was so heartening. You were present, and this was the time it was raining heavily. And you said that the rain gods are blessing us. And from there to now, when we are talking about the results of Sunbeam Sun City and such fabulous results, ma'am, what would you like to say about that?
Vijesh, you know, the other day when somebody had posted this day one's video of Sunbeam Sun City, I had written, it's been a labor of love. And who says dreams do not come true? We have lived a dream. We dreamt a dream and we have lived a dream. So when it comes to Sunbeam Sun City doing anything, I get super emotional, you know. So I feel that I cannot at times be objective also, because I have literally seen the school come up brick by brick, you know, in front of my eyes. For someone like Chairman Sir and Director Ma'am, who have probably seen so many institutions take life before their very eyes, you know, at times every new fledgling school may not be special, but for me, Sun City will always remain extremely special. And it's not just about chronicling the journey of a school which has grown by leaps and bounds in terms of the infrastructure. More than that, I have seen the Sun City students and teaching fraternity evolve year after year. I recall the days when we used to be in the classrooms when we were still developing certain facilities at Sun City, you know, when the teachers, who are all the luminaries of the galaxy of the teaching fraternity at Sun City today, they were all newbies in the Sun City corridors. Okay, how the staff room used to be a small place. Cut to now, felicitations and celebrations of such a sterling result. What does it indicate? It indicates the depth of hard work and effort which has gone into creating this extravaganza of wonderful performances. And with that, I would also like to praise on record my deep sense of gratitude to the parents. मुझे अभी भी वो दिन याद है जब हम सन सिटी में एडमिशंस के लिए इंटरव्यूज लेते थे और पेरेंट्स कहते थे लेकिन ये तो स्कूल शहर से बहुत दूर है, राइट? टू नाउ पेरेंट्स कमिंग एंड सेइंग दैट वी टुक वन लुक एट द स्कूल एंड वी सेड वाओ दिस इज वेयर माय चाइल्ड वांट्स टू स्टडी एंड ऑल अलोंग द पेरेंट्स हैव सपोर्टेड अस बाय बीइंग आवर ऑनेस्ट क्रिटिक्स दे हैव कम एंड शेयर्ड विद अस अबाउट how we should do certain things differently to facilitate better understanding and comprehension for the students, to telling us that, no, ma'am, you're doing so wonderfully well. The hostel, if it has got 700 students today, Gijay sir and all the people who are watching us, I want to say someone placed faith in us, right? Kisi ne aaj se 10-11 saal pehle hame ye vishwas dilaya, ye yakeen dilaya aur ye sahyog diya कि हमारे बच्चे पढ़ेंगे. सो टुडे इट इज नॉट जस्ट अ सेलिब्रेशन ऑफ रिजल्ट्स, इट इज द सेलिब्रेशन ऑफ अ सिनर्जी ऑफ ऑल द स्टेक होल्डर्स ऑफ सनबीम सन सिटी. एंड ऑफ कोर्स आई वुड लाइक टू गिव ट्रेमेंडस क्रेडिट टू माय स्टूडेंट्स. हाउ यू हैव ग्रोन, लुक एट अ यश, लुक एट एन अपूर्वा कॉन्फिडेंटली यू नो कंपेयरिंग दिस एंटायर शो एंड लुक एट द गैलेक्सी ऑफ अचीवर्स दैट वी हैव टुडे बिफोर अस. When I look upon your results, I tell myself that even the impossible can be achieved if there is honesty of effort and if there is a passion. So Sun City class 10 results are the cumulative reaping of the harvest we had sown so many years back. And I would say thank you everyone. What I feel today is that we can set out to achieve anything provided we have a team like this, young, energetic, spirited, willing to take up challenges, and of course, a student fraternity which believes in actually pushing the bar of excellence. You all are wonderful, whether it is academics, whether it is sports. Look at the Sun City corridors, you know, chock a block with trophies. And I have Abhinav sir telling me we need more display zones because my students have won more laurels. And your walls are full of citations and certificates and awards. Way to go, people. I'm so immensely proud of you. And you know what? Our time has just begun. So spread your wings and touch the skies. Proud of you, Sun City students, and proud of you, Sun City teachers. And a big, big thank you to all the Sun City parents. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am, for your words. It's always a pleasure to hear from you. Moving on, we are joined by Ms. Priyambada and her parents. Priyambada has secured 92% in her board exams. Congratulations, Priyambada, and also to her parents.
Priyambada, I would like to ask you that how did you prepare for your examinations?
I prepared for that and I took the help of the teachers. And they are, I would also like to thank all my teachers for being us. And without them, I'm not able to achieve this success. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Priyambada. We'll move further with Ms. Aditi Ambe, who has secured 94.2% in her board exams. Ms. Aditi, to introduce you all, is a Kathak dancer. So congratulations, Ms. Aditi, and also to her parents. हम सब ये जानना चाहते हैं कि चाहे वो नवसाधना कॉम्पिटिशन हो, घात संख्या की प्रस्तुति हो या फिर इंटरनेशनल फिल्म फेस्टिवल में अभिनव हो, अदिति ने बहुत सारे अवार्ड्स जीते हैं और बहुत कुछ अचीव किया है. आज बोर्ड्स के एग्जाम्स में इस नवीन उपलब्धि पर आप क्या कहना चाहेंगे?
This is Aditi here, and I tried my best in every field in whichever I was interested in. That was basically acting, cultural, and my academics. And this is my opinion that academics can never harm us. The passion, whatever you are chasing, that can never harm your studies because instead it enhances your personality. So every child should balance their hobbies and studies both, because it is more good for your personality. And at last, I would like to thank our teachers, our principal ma'am and coordinator to support me for such a great result.
Thank you, Ms. Aditi. सर मैम आप लोग क्या कहना चाहेंगे अदिति की इस उपलब्धि पर?
सभी की बहुत ही मदद मिली मुझे. अमित ठाकुर सर मुझे हमेशा पेरेंट्स की तरह व्यवहार की, और कोऑर्डिनेटर मैम आकांक्षा मैम जो है वो फिल्म में जब मेरी बेटी को काम मिला था उस वक्त बैलेंस करने में मुझे परेशानी आ रही थी वो बहुत सहायता की. मधु मैम डांस और पढ़ाई में दोनों बराबर लेकर चली, उसमें मुझे मदद मिला. फिल्म सेट पर मुझे डायरेक्टर सर और सुमन मैम ने काफी हेल्प किया. इस तरह से सभी की हेल्प से, और इसके पापा केंद्रीय विद्यालय में मैथ के टीचर है तो मैथ से मुझे वहां से सपोर्ट मिला. इस तरह से मुझे सभी जगह से पूरी सपोर्ट मिला. प्रिंसिपल मैम और अनदर सभी स्टाफ सर और मैम सभी ने मुझे बहुत अच्छा लगा.
थैंक यू मैम, थैंक यू सर, थैंक यू अदिति, एंड वंस अगेन आप सभी लोगों को बहुत बहुत बधाई. टू टेक यू फर्दर आई रिक्वेस्ट यश टू इंट्रोड्यूस द नेक्स्ट टॉपर एंड हर पेरेंट्स टू अस.
थैंक यू अपूर्वा. वी हैव अंशी विद हर पेरेंट्स सिक्योरिंग 93.4%. कांग्रेचुलेशंस अंशी सर एंड मैम. सर मैम अंशी एक अंशी बोर्डर है और आपने एक भरोसे के साथ उसे सनबीम सन सिटी हॉस्टल में भेजा था. अंशी की सफलता का श्रेय आप किसे देना चाहेंगे?
अंशी का सफलता का श्रेय उसके टैलेंट पे भी है, टैलेंट जो उसका है, और हॉस्टल का भी जो हॉस्टल का जो आपका डिसिप्लिन है, जो आपकी जो मैनेजमेंट है वो भी बहुत सराहनीय है आपके यहाँ की. इस चीज से मैं सैटिस्फाइड हूँ.
थैंक यू अपूर्वा एंड यश फॉर द हेल्प इन कंडक्टिंग दिस Q&A सेशन. एंड व्हाट आई फील इज दैट the expectations of parents, the expectations of teachers and everyone, their mentors, is ever growing. I don't think we can ever have lesser expectations from our students, and that is expected as well. We feel that our kids will do much, much better, and we'll keep on working hard on it. We'll keep on working towards it to achieve it. And it's very heartening to see that our achievers are engaged in different hobbies and in different fields as well. They are just not studying, they are also developing their personalities. I would now request our Vice Principal Ma'am, Mrs. Sarita Rao, to extend the thank you.
Good afternoon, Jai Hind. And I would like to begin my thought sharing with first congratulating all the parents and then the winners and then all the mentors, and extend my gratitude to the board members for gracing the occasion. It's a valuable and most important thing for a child, the class 10 marks. I think this is the first milestone where the child tries to understand what are the parameters, what is the roadmap for the future, how I have been evaluated in an exam, which is standardized, academic examination, and a lot of things become, the marks makes a lot of difference to the life of students from here onwards, because your streams are now going to be selected, and how you're going to shape your future career also depends on this one examination. So I do understand that it is a very big event and the marks are very important. But as all the dignitaries and my seniors and everyone have already shared, that it may be important, but then this is not the end of all. This is not the last thing which has happened. I would like to reiterate the same thought that this is just the beginning. Much has been said about this examination, your performance, the presentation, and the need that the things that you need to take care of. From here onwards, much more has to be done by each and every student, at least present over here, so that by the time you reach your class 12th, you are very sure what you are supposed to do, what you plan to do, what is your desire to achieve, and with your goal setting, you've already, you know, selected your strategies also. As Director Ma'am said, these are times of pandemic, and you know, these are new normal times. New things are coming. Online classes have been the platform of, you know, teaching and learning. And here we're realizing, we as teachers, we are realizing that all we know is we need to know more. So for all my students, I will say, all that you know, you need to know much more. Blessings, take care, and congratulations, one and all present over here. All the parents, I know ki aapne bahut sari aashayein ki hain aur bahut sari ummeedein aapki aur jaagi hain aapke bachcho ke performance ko dekhkar. Mujhe ummeed hai prayas rahega aur satat prayas rahega ki hum aapke ummeedon pe khare utre aur jaisa hua hai usse dugna tigna chaugna achha kare. Dhanyawad. Thank you.
Thank you so much, ma'am. I would like to thank all the parents, all the teachers, all the staff members, and especially the students, the achievers, to join us today. It was very heartening to have you all as you joined us in this celebration. The celebration will continue, but the hard work will continue more. हमने मेहनत आज तक की है, लेकिन यह मेहनत आगे भी जारी रहेगी क्योंकि ये हमारा ये अंत नहीं है, ये एक शुरुआत है. हम यहाँ से शुरू करेंगे और आगे अपने गोल, अपने अपने अगले पड़ाव पे जाने के लिए और मेहनत करेंगे. सो हार्ड वर्क हैज नॉट स्टॉप्ड, हार्ड वर्क विल कंटिन्यू एंड विल कीप ऑन वर्किंग टुवर्ड्स अचीविंग मेनी मोर अचीवमेंट्स. To remember the journey which has led us here to this momentous occasion, let's visit the times of togetherness through a video presentation of class 10th batch 2019-20. I would request for the video presentation. Thank you. Winston Churchill said, success is not final, failure is not fatal. It is the courage to continue that counts. A message for all our achievers and the ones who aspires to achieve more, to not give up and continue irrespective of the marks you have attained, because marks should not define your future. You should. So before we end, I would request Archana Singh, the principal Sunbeam Sanchi, to say the last few words.
Well, before we leave, I would want to congratulate once again to all the parents and to all the dear students. It's a long journey ahead. We all know that. And we all are going to go together and achieve success. So congratulations once again to all the dear teachers for your hard work, to all the dear parents for their faith, and for all the dear students who have really worked hard for this success. Congratulations. Another celebration we'll have soon. That is what is the dream. And that is what we all live by. Thank you, all of you.
Thank you so much for those encouraging words. I would like to thank all the parents, board members, teachers, and students for joining us today. It was a pleasure hosting you. Stay safe. Thank you, everyone, and Jai Hind.